Shit, I'm gonna need a bigger box once.
Hey, feeling young, but they treat me like the OG. And they want the tea on me, I swear these bitches nosy. Said he put some money on my head, I guess we gon' see. I won't put no money on his head, my niggas owe me. I gotta be single for a while, you can't control me.
We are at $2.4 million in watches.
And I show my face in a case, so you know it's me. Imitation isn't flattery, it's just annoying me. And I'm too about it.
Both of these are both 54,000 more than this Rolls truck.
And I grew about it. Time for y'all to figure out what y'all gonna do about it. Big wheels keep rolling, rolling. I'm outside, 29, G5, Seaside. I've been losing friends and finding peace. But honestly, that sound like a fair trade to me. If I ever heard one and I'm still here outside. Frontline, Southside. I've been losing friends and finding peace. Honestly, that sound like a fair trade to me. Look, don't invite me over if another pity party.
So yesterday we actually had a very, very, very big clients meeting here in Miami with a very prominent guy who you guys probably know very well and have been listening to his music for quite some time. And he actually just got back to us and he's gonna be confirming two RMs. On top of that, I've been working back and forth with a client who is in construction and he was looking at an RM11 since the Las Vegas show. So he just got back to me now. We've been going back and forth now almost a month. So this just goes to show that the number one thing in sales or pursuing a client is persistence. So I followed up with him and now we just spoke about the RM11 Black Knight, which I was explaining to him is a much better investment than the piece that he was looking for initially. So he's probably gonna be going with that. It's on hold actually till 5 p.m. today. And like I said, we sold the Sapphire RM11 Le Mans as well as the RM29 Japan to the very big client. So I can't tell you guys who that is. However, you probably will be seeing that on someone's wrist and just know that it came from TPT.
Nice to see you guys. Hope you all had a great weekend. Today on the wrist, we have the Black Toro. This is a Rafael Nadal, limited to 50 pieces in the world. It's a carbon case with rose gold on the sides. Stunning, fully skeletonized movement. And yeah, 50 in the world, like I said, this watch is available. It's $500,000. If you want it, please feel free to reach out. Got a box and papers and it's beautiful. It's like new.
Muy bien, bro.
Yeah, that's so funny, bro. He wants to actually
aprendido.
Bien.
Sí.
Aprendido mucho. Sí. Represento a mi amigo Rolly.
Neel. Nice to meet you.
How are you, Neel?
Very good, bro.
Neel, what do you have? Do you know what kind of watches I buy?
Yeah.
Do you have something?
What, like Rolex or AP? You buy both, you buy, yes. You even buy
use, what do you have use?
Use Rolex or AP?
Yes.
And the RM you wanna see?
No RM.
No RM right
no.
Now? Okay, let's show him some AP and RM.
Stevie, yeah. Can I pull up?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll see you soon.
Wait, can I see you?
No. Peace.
Wait, bye. How long you think?
20 minutes.
Can I come to you?
Yeah, come.
Okay. All right, I'm gonna come to you.
See you.
Give me your address again.
I got you. Bye.
Peace. Yo, Neel. Steve was gonna come to you, but can you come to him?
Yeah.
Because he's.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
Why are you? Bye. Why are you making Danny ask me, bro? You're good.
No. I was not. He called me. He's like, yo, ask me
for
me. He's gonna say no.
Oh,
no.
Yeah. Right. The fuck.
On the way. Sorry about having to ask you. Just Steve is so shy.
I know, what a little bitch, bro.
I have an IV coming. Yeah, so if you can come to me, that'd be better, actually.
Okay, yeah. I'm gonna come right now, bro. I'll see you in 10.
Yeah, every time Steve wants to talk to you, he's gonna make me call you because that's my job now.
All right, bro, no problem. So yeah, I'll explain again. He bought 3 watches this weekend from me. He just doesn't know when to stop, crazy guy. He said to surprise him. He wants all this week. I'm gonna just call him at random times this week. As you saw, I just gave him his first call. He was dying to see the piece, but gotta wait till he sees it in person. So check in with you guys soon. What's going on, TPT gang? We're here at Stevewilldoit's apartment. Beautiful penthouse. Look at this view, guys. $1 million view. So we're gonna be delivering his first of the three pieces for the week today. Let's see what we got.
I bought 4 Richard Mills in the past, how long?
2 months. Steve spent $2.5 million. He's crazy. I think touching 3 almost after this week.
It's crazy. So, but now I'm moving on to Rolexes because these are just too expensive. These are just way too expensive.
Nothing's expensive for you, bro, but you're building a crazy collection.
This so. Is, I bought 3 from him. 3 crazy ones, and I don't even know which one this is, but
yeah. So this week you're gonna see us 3 times. We're gonna surprise Steve every day with a new watch.
It's like Christmas every day.
What we got today? You ready?
Yo, Sian,
you wanna open it?
I wanna see your reaction if you like it or not.
Wow, dude. Thanks, bro.
No,
that's actually really.
So sick. That's the John Mayer Green Dial Daytona, yellow gold.
If you guys don't know, these are like, this is like a crazy, crazy watch. Crazy. Like, people don't get this watch.
You wait like 5 years to get this watch.
What kind of deal is he getting?
He's getting the best deal always. Timepiece Trading.
Timepiece Trading.
I learned how to work Steiny, bro.
No, Steiny's got the best deal.
Yo, thank you. Timepiece Trading is free chain. Neil's a guy. Thank you, dude. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, how much was that chain?
Thank you. You're giving it to me officially?
Yeah, it's yours.
Bro. Are you serious?
Okay, yeah. Holy I don't fuck. Know how I do it, bro. Holy I don't fuck. Know how I do it for y'all. That's
his chain, bro. 3 weeks ago.
So really? That's yours?
He just came.
Yo, real quick. Yo, I'm selling this right now. Anybody that wants to buy it, DM me. It's for sale, so thank you, bro.
Disrespect. That hurt.
Yeah. You see how the rat gets a free 35?
I'm actually fucking disgusted. I'm sorry.
Bro, right now,
you gotta have something for Bob.
No, we don't want to. I'll take a sticker. If you got a time to trade,
I forgot my cost on it.
But like, my cost is over 25,000, I think.
You are a spoiled little rat.
Yeah, it's yours.
Spoiled little rat.
Thank you, dude.
So this is a frosted AP, I wanted you to see it. That's how it'll look, but I'm gonna get you the skeleton.
How much is it?
It's 215,000. It's limited to 200 pieces. Yo, 200 in the whole world.
This is like a
ball. It looks crazy.
Wait, this side first, always.
That looks insane. I was rocking this yesterday at 500. 50 in the world. So that's a Nadal also. If you see, the dials look kind of similar. But that's a 50 pieces in the world Nadal.
Let me see that.
Half a million.
What?
Yeah.
50
pieces? 50 in the world, yeah.
The fuck is going on?
This one's 30 in the world.
That's fucking crazy,
that's 500K.
Five. What's your... Are you getting this one?
The biggest piece I brought is this. But we've sold... The biggest piece was a $2 million.
So if it cracks, how much is it value?
If it cracks, I'll fix it for 30K-ish, 25K-ish. I'm not gonna make money on fixing it. That's what Richard Mille would charge.
Oh, shit.
Keep selling your bracelet.
Oh, what's wrong with that?
No.
This bracelet's 40K. The big stones.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, my God. You don't play basketball?
That is a piece.
Oh, your box looks better than mine right now.
Shit.
Bro, that's too hard.
Oh. Wait, you're already quarter of your level?
I'm ready
to go. Bro, this is too hard.
Yo.
I like the black and gold.
Damn, that black is actually sick.
It's 50 pieces in the real.
Dude, that black is sexy.
How much is the black one?
Bro, when I first started selling watches, I sold this watch. I sold 3 of them out of 50, like 3 years ago when I first started. I sold them for 180,000. Today they're trading for 550.
So I think this one is gonna go. I think Danny's just gonna switch his out. So you can take this one.
Oh, we're doing this? You're all on for this?
I don't know.
Weren't you gonna give this to Danny though? How are you gonna do that?
No, he's gonna come when Danny sees you.
Me and him will trade.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So it looks like it's diamonds, right?
Is that what Future always talks about?
Yes, frost like.
Yo, shit.
Yeah, it's
an AP frost. Yo, that's crazy.
I'm getting Steve.
Like when he said, got your bust down, AP, this.
That one?
Yeah, this is a real factory frosted AP. Like everyone else is wearing the aftermarket diamonds.
Who else buys for you a lot too?
I mean, like, big people, not, like, I have rich clientele who are, like, low-key. That's what I deal with more.
Who's the one that's, like, that always comes to you, like, having to watch, like,
Steve, for sure.
Damn.
But I have a couple clients like Steve, but they're like, but not too many, maybe 10 or 12 customers like Steve. Steve spent two and a half mil in 2 months, bro. Yeah.
No, but bro, you're not throwing money away. He's not buying a fucking, like, a party. Yeah. He's buying watches that will go up. Like,
you hold them for a year, they should be worth 20% more at least, bro. Really, these are all limited pieces he's getting into. He bought a Nadal. Like, the Nadal is the most solid Richard you can buy.
That looks good.
Oh,
dude, that black one is crazy, bro.
I love this one.
Yeah.
So let me show you, you're not gonna care.
This is the first frosted AP that's not a skeleton that came with the open case back. Like, it's beautiful to look at, actually.
Yeah, this watch is beautiful.
It looks like diamonds, but it's factory frosted white gold.
Like, this is a factory AP. Mm-hmm.
200 in the world. Just dropped, actually. I'm probably the only one in the city with one.
Okay, and I wanna show you this, because you guys are gonna love this. It's Ulysse Nardin. I don't know if you've heard of Ulysse Nardin. Have you heard of it?
No.
A Russian brand. But this is an erotic minute repeater. So watch what the dial does.
Oh, I've seen that.
It's crazy.
That's sexy.
It's platinum, factory diamonds.
That's oh my god.
Like, she's jacking them off. And so what it does, look, so if you're blind and you cannot see the time on your watch, listen to this, okay? The first dong will tell you how many hours you just went through. Like, so right now the time on this watch is 7:34, right?
Okay.
So the first dong will be like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then it'll go, the second dong will be like 15, quarter of an hour. So it'll be dong dong will mean 30. And then smaller dongs will indicate the minutes after the 15 minute marker that we've reached. So you got it?
No. You guys got it?
I'll explain. It's hard to... 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. See? Look. Two. It went two and then four. So two means 15, 30, and then 4 minutes after that. So you hear the time without looking at the time. It's pretty cool.
What?
It's a minute repeater.
That's what you need when you're
playing. Yeah.
The only cool Ulysse Nardin that people know. It's been a collectible for years. Like, it's pre-owned, but it's got box on papers. You want me to put it on you?
Yeah.
It's factory diamonds, dude, platinum, erotic minute repeater.
I don't know, I kind of like that one.
So like, bro, you know what a tourbillon is, right, Steve?
No.
You don't? Like, that's one of the most advanced watchmaking movements that you can have, a tourbillon. A minute repeater is the only thing more complicated. You literally use the sound to tell time, right? So it's pretty cool.
That's insane.
And if it was a Richard Mille, you'd be looking at like a $5 million price tag if it was a Richard Mille minute repeater. That's called the Toro, by the way, the black Toro.
This one's cool.
Here, so you pull this down and it'll do it.
So ridiculous.
I don't even get the logic. It's like, what's the dumbest thing that Steve could buy?
Let me set the time and do it with the real time, and I want you to see how cool this is. Like, don't get it. But this is 18 in the world. This is number 8. Like, 8 is, I don't know if you know, the luckiest number. Like, this piece will be easy to sell.
I heard it was 7.
It is, bro. 8, like, for all of Asia, bro.
Yeah. I think I like this one a lot.
Like, the cheapest.
It's like a collector's watch.
You can't get a minute repeater for less than 150,000 from a shit brand. Ulysse Nardin is a good brand. Like, Google it, check it out. It's not tight, right? Okay.
Yeah.
So the first dong, listen, is gonna be the hour. So yeah, you hear 6, that means it's 6 o'clock,
and
right?
And then the two dongs after is 15 each, or whatever.
It could be four, right?
15.
Yes, and then the single ones after minutes. That, the smallest, are the minutes in singular, okay? Yeah. So tell me what the time is with the minute repeater. Don't look at the time. That's it, right? That's it? So what does that mean?
I heard six.
There were only six big dogs,
yeah,
dongs,
so
right?
And I heard one.
You heard one after?
So
but you heard one.
One
after a long time.
Six
it was just, yes, exactly.
Yeah. Bro, the watch collection now is like,
yeah,
getting unreal.
I think I have to give you another box, bro. Another box. The one we use in the store.
Yeah, so we have two more Rolexes coming.
Yeah. I brought that just for fuck's sake.
Yeah.
Like, I want to show these guys this.
I've seen it before. It's pretty popular. Viral, yeah.
Very popular watch, yeah. 18 in the world, like, the number is good too. Like, selling these limited watches, when you have a good number, it's like easy to find a buyer, right? We just got it last week.
So Neel originally came here to give me this because I bought three Rolexes from him. So this is 3 days of Christmas. Today's first day is the green face Daytona. And then I ended up trading in my Johann Richard Mille and getting, what's this one called?
That's the Black Toro. The 50 black, in the world. It's an adult.
50 in the world. This is a pretty penny. And then I got the blind person watch.
Which, minute repeater.
Which is amazing. Because look. They're f***ing.
Yeah.
This is called Frosted.
Frosted.
Factory eight. Frosted by Audemars Piguet.
200 in the world, right?
In the whole world, yeah.
Brand new.
Just dropped.
This is crazy.
Yeah, that's nuts.
Dude, once I get
the, ran out of space, bro. Yeah.
Once I get the other two Rolexes.
Game over. I think I have another box. I do have another box.
Dude, I came here with this fool. I got a gold. How old are you, bro?
23.
What? I don't think I've ever seen that in my life.
Shit, I'm gonna need a bigger box once the. Because after, because we have two more Rolexes.
I got you, bro. I'm gonna give you the one that we use in the store to display our watches.
Dude, once I get. This is the craziest watch collection that probably ever.
I would die to own that collection. Like, I own it in my business.
You own it
I do own it, but like, it's not all mine, you know? Okay, this watch I would never wear, even though I was dying to, because it's brand new. Same with this.
Like, you bought all of these from you?
Yeah, but what I'm saying is, like, even though it was my collection, it was for sale, right? It wasn't my personal collection. Like, I would love to have worn this, bro. I was dying to wear it, but it's a new watch, so I can't wear a brand new watch, right? Like this I was wearing because it was pre-owned.
Yo, this is like this.
Well, Steve, you know your warranty's in here, obviously. Please keep it safe. I owe you a warranty for the Richard Mille. I owe you the box and paper for both of these. All right, I'll deliver it tomorrow. Your Rolex shit is here. It's right on the toolkit. Crazy guy. Congrats.
Thanks, bro.
Jeez. Yeah.
Yes. That is crazy.
We're already at a 1.1 million. Here's the Nadal, valued at 450,000 market value. We're at now 1.55 million. The Le Mans Classic, valued at 300,000. We're at 1.85 million, guys. Ulysse Nordin Minute Repeater Erotic, valued at 225,000. 1.85 plus 225. So we're at $2,075,000. $2 million in just watches, and we haven't even finished. All right, here's another $250,000. So we're now at 2.325 million. And to top it off is another $80,000 watch. We are at $2.4 million in watches within 2 months.
Plus we have two more.
But let's wait to see what this is worth in a year. Like, it's gonna be crazy.
This is crazy. This is a beautiful, beautiful thing.
That's unreal, bro. Actually, I never knew it was that one. Shit.
Hey Sean, what's up, bro?
What's up, bro? How are you?
Chilling.
Just doing some WhatsApp rounds, trying to get some stuff happening. Just sold a VC and trying to get this bracelet fixed because our clasp broke. So trying to get that sorted out. What's going on with you?
Not much. Just been editing our video that's supposed to drop tomorrow. But I want to show you something.
What is it, bro?
Here, take the camera.
I'm taking this?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, so you already know. So this is the app that you can never get right on.
Don't even do this.
You know, you already
right
know.
Now,
you know.
Don't
the
even
speakers
do this to me right now.
You already know, like. So check me out. You feel me?
You gotta be kidding me, bro. Don't even tell me. Don't even tell me.
You feel me? Para mi familia.
Yo, this is just not even right, bro. This is honestly, bro. This is not fair. This, yo, take this camera back.
Bro. I'm done with you, bro. That's some bullshit. I'm over here rocking the foam Air Force Ones. Like, I don't even know what's good with these, bro. No one even knows about these, bro. Actually, I'm gonna hide my shit because I can't win anything on sneakers. So. It's embarrassing, bro. It's actually embarrassing, bro. Unbelievable.
Oh, I knew you were gonna feel it.
Yo, get those out of here, bro. I don't wanna be seeing those anymore, bro. It's not right. Today's a big day. I think I told you guys previously that we were waiting for this guy to come. Finally arrived this morning. Factory setting rainbow. This is the craziest part. 2021 card, brand new. Probably one of the last ones that will ever be sold.
We're about to track the 48 for the first time. Should be a lot of fun. Who are we about to race, Tyler? We're about to race 6ix9ine and Stevewilldoit and Aaron. So should be fun. Three Lambos and Ferrari.
That's like
that looks
sexy. That's blue, right?
That's matte blue.
That's, oh, the yeah. Orange makes it. That orange is fire.
Oh yeah, interior is orange? Damn. Oh,
fire.
Oh.
That's blue.
Hard. Yeah, the stars, everything. Like a hard, hard.
You know what's funny?
Like that?
I paid $496 for this.
Neel, you're that? I paid $496 for that.
Which one's more? This is more. Yeah, this is more than that. Both of these are both $54,000 more than this Rolls truck.
Damn.
Only Steve will do it. Bro, we should definitely do a couple laps before we race. Yeah. For sure.
He's supposed to be less than four cars. You guys can go like three or four.
Yeah. Okay. Let's. But I mean, let everyone do a lap like how we did, and then
fuel it out. Let fucking.
That's a sick track. Yeah. There's like two or three very sharp turns. Like you need to slow down.
You will get fucked up if you're not paying attention.
The bank. Did you hit the bank?
I hit it. I drifted like two or three turns. Very nice, bro. Like fully sideways.
That's what we need to see, bro.
I want the GoPro, bro. Like that'll be crazy for
them.
If you just want to use the straightaways, I can move the cones. So all you're doing is the oval.
Yeah.
If that's what you guys want.
We gotta make the layer and there.
All right, so you want me to pull all the cones?
I'm trying to film this.
So, okay, we'll do that. So, but let's just make sure we're all going the same direction. Yeah, no stopping in the middle of the track, none of that. If you want to get off the track, just come into one of these breezeways and come in here. Let's not go all the way down there and come back this way.
But guys, if y'all have a problem, just put your hazards on.
With the Rolls Royce tip over.
As long as you stay at like a normal highway speed, you're fine.
Oh
yeah.
I can pull my truck up there and stop, and it's fine.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Yeah, because I was on that shit and I felt like it was about to whoop.
Yeah.
I don't think it will. I put bigger trucks up there. It should be fine. But I mean, if you don't feel safe doing it, don't do it.
Don't do it.
All right. So we're all good.
Very different watch.
Man, that's the Johan Blake.
Yeah.
Text the drone guy.
Like yeah, I can see you. Like you can see.
It's like some creepy skeleton murder people.
I don't know about that.
Let me clean it, bro.
Yeah, I'm thinking, man, but we gotta wait.
That was crazy.
That was sick. Georgie, have you fucked yet?
Yeah, boo.
Alright guys, so this morning I wanted to talk about RMs, the state of the market, and also go over a pretty impressive sold box. I'm even impressed myself after selling RMs for, you know, 3 years now, specializing in them. This is pretty crazy. So I'm gonna walk you through this. I'm gonna explain to you how RM dealing works and also, you know, how deals are being structured. So typically most clients that are in the RM game, as far as end clients, they're not going to be straight selling to you. If they are giving you a piece, typically they're trading up or they're trading down depending on the size of the piece. And it's honestly the same amongst dealers. So for instance, a lot of the big RM guys, which to be honest with you, as far as like big series RM dealers in the world, there's only really a handful. I would say probably maybe 10 very serious, you know, heavy stock guys. So these guys know the game very well, just like us. So I'm gonna break it down for you guys. So over here in the sold box, we have a few pieces. So this just goes to show, you know, what we're selling. Actually, about everything in this box was sold within the last 7 days, which is pretty impressive. So let's look at all the pieces. I'm gonna tell you how they got sold and what's going on over here. So we'll start over here. This is an RM 11 titanium. I was alluding to this previously. This is for our boy Mike RM plug. This is going out to one of his clients. Next up, we have an RM 11 carbon. So both of these guys right here, these are gonna be straight sales. So this was actually a dealer bought this from us, and also another dealer bought this carbon from us. So dealer called me up. He was looking at an 1103 titanium or another 11. I pitched him on the RM 11 carbon, much better investment in my opinion. So he picked this guy up for his client. So these two are straight sales. Next up, we have an RM 6701 titanium. So 67 is very popular. A lot of RM dealers actually don't carry 67s. They are a little bit of a different market than I would say like 11s, 30s, 55s, 35s. So it takes a particular guy. However, a great watch, and honestly, in my opinion, a little bit undervalued for what it is. So this is actually going out to my very good friend, Christian. This is actually his third 67. So he's went through the first two, the titanium and the white gold. He sold both of them back to me, made a healthy profit, and now he's on to number three. Next up over here, we have a big boy. So this is the RM 11 Black Knight. This is limited 100 pieces. This guy is actually going off to a retail client who's going to wear it and enjoy it, one of our retails. And he actually traded his RM 11 Sandblast in towards the Black Knight. So we'll show you guys the Sandblast when it comes in, just so you can get an idea. Next up over here, we have an RM 30. This is gonna be the RM 30 Venezuela. So really cool piece. I was talking about this previously. We picked it up. If you check out the back, we have the Venezuelan flag with the red rehot all the way around. Really beautiful watch. Just got it cleaned up for a nice retail client. Once again, another straight sale. This one actually went to a dealer who's gonna be resold to a client for a small markup. Following that, this guy actually happened this morning. This is a 6702 Alexander Zverev. Ultra thin black and TPT. This one is 2019 full set. This one was picked up by a dealer in Hong Kong, my very good friend Bernard. Bernard, if you're out there watching, thank you so much, bro. You've given me some amazing pieces over the past year. I really appreciate your business, and I'm excited to get our first RM deal in the books. Following that, we actually have another straight sale. So this is the RM29 Japan and TPT limited 50 pieces. This guy is watch only, and this is an RM 11 Le Mans titanium with an aftermarket sapphire case conversion. Comes with both cases. Once again, a naked watch, another straight sale. So as you can see here, there's a little bit of diversity. Some of these guys are going off to retail clients, some are going to dealers. It just goes to show, you know, that the RM market is interesting because you might have a client in Dubai, for instance, and in order to get that watch to a client in Dubai, it might have to go from a guy in New York to us in Florida, to a guy in Hong Kong, to a guy in Dubai. You know, each time it's being sold, a little bit marked up, sold a little bit marked up, and then it gets to the final destination. Sometimes you're lucky enough to meet an end user. You give them an amazing price on a piece. Typically, if you're an RM dealer, you have a lot more end users that are looking for RM just because you're known for it. So we're able to give our customers a little bit of a better price just because we have, you know, the original true cost. It's not being marked up anywhere, right, and there's no brokers in between. But check that out. Pretty impressive sold box, guys. Take a guess what the total value of this sold box is, and whoever guesses it will get a merch pack. So check it out. Bro, when you said you were bringing a gift, I didn't know that you brought half of Canada with you, bro.
Yeah, exactly. So.
fragile?
How do you even guess what that is?
Should I be worried? I'm like excited but nervous.
Something alive in it?
That's what happens.
Steven's gonna come out of here or what?
That's what happens when people don't pay in Canada.
I was actually talking to my client. He was telling me that Canada is actually pretty crazy right now. Apparently you can't even walk around in downtown with a watch. Is that true?
No, you gotta be careful. It has gotten bad. Chicks are pretty bad, not the guys.
That's always the worst.
Chicks.
I'm excited, bro. Thank you. I don't even know what's in here yet. I'm getting nervous. Getting very nervous. Yo, what is this? What is this, bro? What is going on in here?
Hello. Hey, what's going on? Yeah, that one's just gonna cost me about 700,000.
Bro.
No, this is a brand new model. I'm trying to spank a new model, that 65. They were selling them for a mil. I can get a really good deal on that.
You want armbar?
Huh? We felt like 750 on that.
I had a Richard prior to these. That's the joke.
Yo, that is fucking sick for the straps.
Yeah.
Yo, bro, that is fucking crazy. What?
My friend's in the industry.
Hey, I'm just sitting with some right
now. Fucking bro, that is so fly.
Y'all just changed the game, bro. Now you can stop putting them in the bags.
Yo, that is the brand that is the craziest thing I've ever seen.
That's sick.
Yo.
You just push it. Oh, okay.
Dude, that is wild. That is crazy wild. That is insane.
Fuck, they damaged a little bit here. I was going to kill them. You just got to touch them.
Oh my god.
Wow.
That is still so here.
So when we pull out our straps, you put them under the plastic bags and they look so weird.
That's what I'm saying. So I saw you guys like, oh, get away.
Yeah, I think that's the coolest thing that anyone's ever brought us for sure. That is so crazy.
You know how rare
I didn't even know they make stuff like this.
You know how rare that is?
You hear that, Sean?
I mean, I have an idea where it came from.
Rare, rare birds for sure.
This you never see outside the store. That's ridiculous. I barely even see them in the store now. They have the straps in the back and in another safe that they're guarding for their lives. It's so crazy. I honestly, I can't believe it. I can't believe it. Thank you so much. That's insane. Now I really have to hook you guys up. So now we have to take a look at some real deals. That's insane. Wow.
Oh, look who it is!
Remove the movement yourself.
This guy.
It's our employee!
Check his fit today, though. Check his fit. Because he's fly as a motherfucker right now.
Come on. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you got the purse today, right? Hey.
This is the only guy, actually, probably one of the only guys that changes his RM strap every day to match his fit.
Always.
I've never seen it before.
Different strap, different watch, different fit. You know the vibes. And the wire hit, by the way. Stop playing with me. Half a mil, straight through.
Follow the boy. Follow the boy. Here's his IG.
No cap.
Yeah, pop it up on the screen. Give our boy some love.
What's up, baby? How you feeling?
Bro, I heard check his fit and I have to come see.
Bro, you big JP, you got the Amiri on?
The fits are so crazy that people come in from other rooms to check them out, bro. They come flying in from other parts of the office.
Yes, sir.
They have the best fight. It's top of shit.
So, bro. How are you doing, man? All good. How are you?
Good.
Good to see you, man.
Hi, how are you?
That's my dad.
Nice to meet you.
We met each other. You met
him? Yeah, I know. I met him at
the party on the roof.
Yeah,
the
rooftop.
I remember. You're tall, bro.
It's hard to miss, huh? How are you doing? Everything good?
Good. You?
Yes, sir.
Check his watch.
Ah, shit.
That's like a lot. It's like the...
It's exactly. So they make it in different colors.
I like more the champ.
The chain. Yeah, the chain is for sale also. Everything's for sale.
How much is this?
The chain is 55,000. Half a kilo.
55,000.
For the right price, you know, everything gets sold for the right price.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
Yeah, that's
it's awesome. Two-tone look you see from the back. Beautiful. 18 karat gold or?
It's
14
karat. It's 14, I think.
Beautiful. Yeah.
So this is a yellow gold tourbillon.
Wow. Quite a surprise. Richard Mille. How, the cheaper one of Richard Mille?
You're gonna be looking at like this, which is the RM10. This is white gold.
White gold, how much is this?
Around.
That's cheap.
Yeah, it's very cheap. don't, and we're gonna take that off. That's not even what's on the site.
A good addition.
Just so you see what I'm doing for you guys.
Y'all wear the blue
coat. I got it. Yeah.
We'll bleep it.
We're gonna bleep that 100%, bro, because then I'm gonna get people texting.
No, yeah, no way. No way.
That's around 250.
Not cheap at all.
Look at this. That one's beautiful.
This one's beautiful too. So this is Jacob Bugatti. I don't know if you've seen it.
Bugatti, like the car?
The car, yeah. Oh, by Jacob and Co.
Huh?
Jacob and Co. So look, if you see here.
All right, so I want to document this because this is pretty crazy. So we actually have, I told you guys in the last video, we bought a kite. Actually, we bought two kites, but it gets even crazier. Check this out. We actually have three kites. So these are the rose gold titanium black DLC. This is the full black DLC black kite. So you'll probably never get a shot to see this again. Three kites in the same room. This is limited 30. These guys are limited 30, so pretty crazy. These two are sold. They're going off to clients today. And the black kite is in stock. I think Neil's gonna keep this for himself. Awesome piece.